Hey everybody, and welcome to my WWE Monday Night Raw 12/23/13 review, the final Raw before Christmas this year. It's amazing to me that it is already Christmas Eve here, so Merry Christmas to those that celebrate, but happy holidays to those who do not, for whichever holiday you do celebrate. I hope you enjoy it with your family. So anyway, let's get into this review. Obviously, this show was one that I did not have a ton of high expectations for, considering the fact that, let's just be honest here, it's a holiday episode. Next week is going to be the same kind of thing with a New Year's Raw. So clearly, we are not going to be expecting a whole lot out of this. It's kind of just one of those deals where you say to yourself, I understand that this is not going to be the same kind of show where you're building up storylines and all of that. So, I mean, to be as critical as you may normally be is kind of not fair in a way. I still will be giving an honest review of what I thought of things, but again, with a grain of salt, because I understand that this show is not on the same threshold, the same platform as a normal Raw like would be. So first of all, you get the Authority coming out with their Santa hats on, and Kane giving out candy canes, including to a kid who clearly didn't want them, but he decided to shove a few in his face anyway. And them coming in the ring and announcing some of the matches tonight, the six-man tag main event, the Divas match, and the couple of the other ones. And Mark Henry and Damian Sandow, the Battle of the Santas. So that was kind of the overall premise of the show, I guess. It was like one of the main matches they were looking to build up on. Orton coming out and kind of thanking them for the night off, so he was not going to be on any of the remainder of the show. They all hug, and that's the end of that. So yippee for the Authority. You didn't see them for the rest of the show. No Orton for the remainder of Raw. Interesting choice. So we start off the matches, which was the majority of everything tonight, with a 12 Diva Jingle Bells match. So it was the Total Divas and the non-Total Divas, as if we haven't seen enough of that. So that was Eva Marie, the Funkadactyls, the Bellas, and Natalya beating Caitlyn, Summer Rae, Alicia Fox, Vicky Guerrero, Tamina, and Oksana. And I will say this match made me laugh. I definitely got a joy out of it because it was funny. Wee bad, like it was so not enjoyable that it was funny as a result, especially when Vicky Guerrero like did her little like use her antlers. But yeah, so the Total Divas versus non-Total Divas crap continues yet again. Of course, it's incorporated into the holiday special in any way we can. Yippee, what a great opening match. By the way, Eva Marie sucks in every way. She can't work at all. It's, like, horrible. Like, her, when she, like, dragged, I don't even remember who she was in the ring with, but when she dragged one of them down, she, like, did it way before they were ready to take the fucking bump, but, like, it just, God. But yet, she gets TV time, and yet JoJo does not, and I think JoJo probably would do better, but what do I know? So Sin Cara versus Curtis Axel was the next match, and I enjoyed this match myself, actually. I thought this was decent, and I think that the new Sin Cara, a la Unico, is actually a much better person to be under the mask. You actually hear a little bit of English coming from him, because the guy can actually speak it. Not only that, but I mean, this match, yeah, it's kind of random, sure, but I mean, it wasn't too bad, and on top of that, at least it was something for these two guys, and Sin Cara goes over, and that's that. So, you get Damian Sandow talking about how he doesn't care what a little girl wants for Christmas, and he's here to cancel it and everything. I thought Sandow was actually a really good bad Santa. If there's a guy to play a bad Santa, I think Damian Sandow is one of the best ones you could choose from. I think that was awesome that they chose him. That's great. You also get Wade Barrett outside the arena ringing a bell, kind of acting like a charity would to donate for the holidays, you know, to give back to those that are in need and everything. And in reality, he ended up saying at the end that there is no charity he's associated with and all this money is coming back to me. I thought that was pretty cool, actually, a good way to use him on this show. And then you get a six-man tag match which is the Wyatt family taking on Cody Rhodes and Goldust and Daniel Bryan. This was a very good six-man tag match. I enjoyed it quite a bit. And with the Wyatt family going over, I definitely like that as well. This was a solid matchup throughout. I would like to see these two matches split off at the Royal Rumble, you see. So this is potential Rumble build here. Not a ton on this show, not much at all, actually. But this is some potential Rumble build up here. You could have maybe Bryan versus Bray Wyatt, and you could have maybe Cody and Goldust versus Harper and Rowan, and maybe you get Harper and Rowan taking the tag straps from them at Rumble. I wouldn't be shocked. That would be good, in my opinion. They're kind of building it up that way, at least. And this was a good match that I thoroughly enjoyed, so I was quite happy with. So then we get another segment with Mark Henry instead, saying that because the kid is all scared about Christmas being canceled, and he says that he'll save Christmas. And again, Mark Henry might not have been everyone's first choice for the Good Santa, but I certainly was fine with it. I think Mark Henry is fun. I like Mark Henry's character, whether it's face or heel. Mark Henry is always an enjoyable guy to watch. So, but then you get... Oh boy, then you get a singing contest between Xavier Woods and R-Truth, 2MB, because apparently Heath Slater is out for some time, and Kali and Santino Marella. So you get three pairs of guys, and you get Kali just saying, fa-la-la-la-la, and they end up winning it somehow. Drew McIntyre and Jinder Mahal were doing a great job of singing themselves. It's nice and screechy. And Xavier Woods actually had a solid voice, with R-Truth just annoyingly saying random words in there. But yeah, so Kali and Santino end up winning, and then the two-man band tries to attack, and then they end up going over anyway. And then they all sing together, and Kali sing, he doesn't even know what's going on. So it's a wonderful segment. That was very, very great. I'm so glad it was on the show. So the next match actually had a point to it, and it was called a present on a pole match, which was Dolph Ziggler versus Fandango. Now, yeah, this match, again, they've had these two guys actually go at it a couple of times, and the winner gets the present, which is a number one contenders match to the IC title. So it actually made some kind of sense in some way, shape, or form. Fandango ended up winning. Dolph Ziggler took a great bump at the end. It was actually decent, served its purpose, and Fandango goes over, gets the IC title match against Big E Langston. Fine by me. This is two consecutive pay-per-views. They've had a number one contenders match for the IC title. It's a step in the right direction as far as, like, you know, the picture for the mid-card belt might go. Now, I'll say this much. I don't think it's like, that doesn't mean that, oh, this IC title means a ton now, and, oh, I feel so differently about it, and blah, 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 I feel great now. It's like, this is now awesome. Don't get me wrong. I do not feel like their mid-card is now great. I don't feel like they're building up the IC title matches great now just because there's number one contenders matches or, like, a match that determines who gets the shot at it, but it certainly makes the title feel a little more prestigious when you're actually fighting to get a shot at it. So that is a step in the right direction. It is the beginning of hopefully better things to come. So I will say that I like that. And it's a way to use the Christmas concept, but at the same time actually do something. So that was good. Then you get a tag match, the Usos versus the Primetime Players, and you get good old Darren Young, messing up what city they were in, saying that they were in Houston when they were in fact in Austin, so they gave him shit for the rest of that match, and he will get shit for a while probably because of it, just like R-Truth did when he said Green Bay or Milwaukee or whatever city they weren't in Wisconsin. Same deal there. This matchup, though, wasn't too bad. Good tag match. I wouldn't mind seeing these two teams actually just either have, not really a feud because they're both face teams, but I wouldn't mind seeing these two teams go at it a little more often. I like each of them. Usos went over, which is fine by me. I mean, the little Rudolph thing at the end was a little bit like, why is that happened? But this match was just proof that the Usos, how over the Usos are, especially once Darren Young messed up what town they were in. Obviously, that makes the Usos the faces here even more, and the Primetime Players are going to get shit, even though Titus had nothing to do with it. And it was pretty funny, though, when Titus was saying that he won't let him talk because of that. I definitely thought that was pretty cool. It seemed like he almost messed that up, not even legitimately. I mean, it might have been a planned thing, but it almost seemed like he was saying, like, you would never let me talk, and then he made the wrong choice of words. It was kind of funny. But And then we get the Battle of the Santas match, which was Mark Henry defeating, obviously going the good Santa, beating the bad Santa. No shocker there. I mean, if anybody thought the bad Santa was winning, I think you're out of your mind. But I did read something on like on a website about how people were like, there was actually some people that were legitimately worried about Christmas being canceled because of the Mark Henry and Damian Sandow match. Like, as if that is going to have any kind of effect on Christmas really happening. Like, please, dear God, tell me that you didn't really think that. That scares me, if anyone actually thought this match had a bearing on Christmas. Man. But Mark Henry went over with ease. It was a little bit entertaining, but I really wasn't into it. I didn't enjoy it, I'll say that much. But I thought like it was trying to entertain you in some way, shape, or form. And I don't think it failed at it, but it wasn't like something that I was going, oh my God, this is greatness. Or I wasn't like on the floor laughing. Like, I was laughing much harder at like the Divas match and like a couple of these other things. Like, I actually was laughing and kind of enjoying myself. I was much more into like the Present on a Pole match than say this one. I don't know. It just, one of those things. Again, it's a holiday show, so you take it with a grain of salt. So CM Punk says he's glad he doesn't, that he has a couple of partners for tonight. He's thankful for that. He doesn't ask for much, but he certainly got his Christmas present by being awarded Big E, Langston, and John Cena as his partners, and they cut a little backstage segment where they kind of mock the Shield and say believe in that, which was not too bad. That was actually a solid segment to build up your main event. So you get the Los Matadores defeating Real Americans in a tag match. Another one that was kind of thrown together here, but Los Matadores end up getting the victory. Not a match that I really was enjoying too much. I mean, I will say this, Cesaro swing was pretty good, of course, as always. But outside of that, I mean, this wasn't really too much of a ridiculously great match. One thing I'll say is this much, I'm not really sure what they're doing with the Real Americans. It's hard to say because, like, 1 week the Real Americans are, like, beating the tag team champions, and the next week they lose to Los Matadores, who have hardly been on TV in the last 6 weeks or more. So I don't really know what to assume here with these two teams, or with the Real Americans especially. My one of the best things I think that can happen with the Real Americans is Antonio Cesaro becoming the face and turning on Swagger and them having a feud over the U.S. belt. But, you know, again, that's just my honest opinion. That's just that. Or you could turn Cesaro heel and have Swagger be face, and Cesaro kind of bring back the European belt and have the European and U.S. belts, and oh my God, the mid-card's good. But, you know, who am I to say anything of such stupidity? I would never know what I'm talking about, right? No, just mocking some of the professionals that say that, you know, us fans would never understand anything. But, okay. We got Ryback defeating Kofi Kingston in the next match, which was completely random. Ryback actually wins, my God. And Kofi, no shocker here, loses another match. So that's wonderful. Absolutely the most boring match of the night for me. I don't even know if I watched 10 seconds of this match outside of the finish, really. I didn't care. I didn't care. There was no reason for me to care. By the way, The Miz was acting like a face once again on SmackDown last week. So where the hell is Miz going? It just goes to show you they have no clue what they're doing with guys like him, but whatever. Then we get the six-man tag main event, which was Punk, Langston, and Cena defeating Shield via DQ. The DQ finish isn't something I'm too upset about. Big E Langston getting such a big spot is great for him. That's really, really nice for a guy like a Big E to be getting such a big spot. I don't always love DQ finishes, and I, of course, I'm not, like, thrilled with this one either, but it was an okay match. It wasn't too bad. I don't think it was something that you could say to yourself, wow, this was such a memorable Shield match, because, I mean, the Shield are one of the best trios I can remember, like, consistently putting on enjoyable matches as a trio. They have done that. And then some, but this wasn't one of the matches I'd take away as greatness. But I will say Big E Langston nearly getting the victory for the team was pretty cool. And then end up them ending up getting over by the end of the show was good as well. And then I thought that that was good. Again, like I said, you know, you could be building up Punk and Cena and Langston as the three guys that take on the Shield. I mean, I don't even know what. I mean, you know, you're seeing Fandango and Langston for the IC belt. I don't really know. They have Langston going in three different directions right now. Now they have him involved with the Shield here tonight. I mean, that might just be a one-time thing just to help out the cause. But, I mean, they have him teaming with Henry. They also have him feuding with, apparently now going to be Fandango for the IC belt. So it's like, you know, you got three different things going for Big E, which is good. It goes to show that they have, like, a lot for him. But at the same time, what direction are they going to really, truly go in? I'm hoping that what we get is a combination where Mark Henry actually turns on Big E down the line and fights him for the IC belt. I'd be fine if that was the WrestleMania match, because then that's a huge win for Big E Langston at WrestleMania. That would work for me. But either way, as far as the main event goes, you know, again, it's a holiday show, so I don't, you know, go crazy over it not really being too much of a show that built up a lot for the Royal Rumble. But one thing that I have not talked about yet, and anybody who's anybody knows that they've been waiting for me to say this, but the announcement and the vignette and the ridiculousness of Batista returning to the WWE, and that was easily the thing about this show that excited me the most. Now, of course, you know, there's nothing better than when a guy returns when you don't expect it, so that would have been even more exciting for as a moment. But let me say this much, even just the seeing the vignette is amazing. I have heard about the leaked return thing on whatever, and I think that they did that as more of a last second, like, well, the people already know he's coming back, so let's just throw a video package together. I don't know if that's exactly what happened or not, but either way, he's coming back January 20th, 2013, and I could not be more excited for it. It honestly made me mark out, made me very excited. I cannot wait to see Batista come back. Batista has been one of my favorite guys from the post-Attitude era. Ever. I loved him in Evolution. I loved when he was the World Heavyweight Champion. And then I loved him even as the heel that he became toward the end of his run, when he was feuding with John Cena, when he was talking about the kissing babies and hugging, kissing babies and hugging fat girls, and you can't see me, you can't see me, you want some, come get some, you want some, come get some, and all that shit. And he always had the security around him, and it, man, I'll tell you, some of those heel promos that he was cutting toward the end were fucking golden. But so were some of him as a babyface works too. He works either way. But I can't wait to see what Batista does. I am so thrilled to have him back as part of the WWE. I cannot wait to see him come back. I really can't. I was disappointed when he left in 2010, and it will be almost 4 years later, but he is back, and man, is it going to be exciting to see. No matter who he targets, no matter who he faces, no matter what happens, I still hope that Batista has a good run when he comes back. And even if it is only for a few months, I think it'll be great to see another great, great guy coming back. So that should be fun. Overall, though, this show was, like, you know, okay for me. I had moments where I was enjoying it, either laughing, getting entertained in some way, shape, or form. A couple of the matches had made sense and were decent. So there were things about this show that worked for me. There were things about this show that were, like, completely, like, okay. Like, I think the last hour or so, really, out of anything, was just really kind of dragged. But other than that, I think that this was an all right show. I mean, honestly, you kind of go into it with a different kind of expectation, as I've already mentioned, because of the fact that it's a holiday show. So, I mean, you don't really go into it thinking to yourself that this is going to be, like, one of the best Raws you've seen in years. So, I mean, you know, next week's the same thing, especially since the preview of it had Big Show dancing around with a very small amount of clothing on. I don't know if I really want to watch that one. Either way, this was like a C show for me, no real Rumble buildup. And, you know, I'm not going to, you know, get too on them about that, just because it's still early, A, and B, it was a holiday show, so I'm not expecting a ton. But, I mean, I would like some Rumble buildup. It is one of your big pay-per-views, so I wouldn't mind them starting to build it up before the last, like, 2-3 weeks before the Rumble. But anyway, that go-home show is going to be great just because Batista is returning on it. We'll see what he does, how he makes his impact on his return. I don't know if he's going to participate in the Rumble, immediately feud with Orton, do whatever. I don't care. I'm absolutely cool with whatever. I think Batista can be used in any kind of role. Again, he can be used as a face, heel, etc. He can feud with almost anybody, and he's coming back to do some big matches, so I think it'll be exciting. to see him. That's the best part of this whole show for me. That was my number one highlight. But as far as other good moments go, I thought the Wade Barrett stuff was fucking phenomenal. I thought the six-man tag with the Wyatts, Cody Goldust, and Bryan could be good. I could split that off into a couple matches for the Rumble pay-per-view. Main event was at least decent, did its purpose. The president on a pole match, same deal. I see it was a few good things out of this show to look at. But most importantly, I hope everybody, to get off topic about the show, was see, average, whatever. Just hope everybody enjoys their holiday season. I'm hoping everybody is already enjoying their holidays, and if you do celebrate Christmas or whatever, just to remain politically correct, if you do celebrate Christmas, then I hope everybody has a Merry Christmas and enjoys time with their families, because this is that time of year where that's a very important thing to make sure you do, you know, because you never know how long you're going to have them for. To be honest. I hope everybody has a nice holiday, though, and I will not be making any more videos until after Christmas is come and gone. This will be the last one for me until probably the end of the week. I may be doing a TNA review this week. You might see one. It's become kind of rare for me to be doing them, but wouldn't mind doing a few topic videos over the course of this week or something along those lines. Maybe be looking at early Royal Rumble predictions, maybe some returns that I could maybe see coming, things like that. So that might be a good topic video to be uploading sooner rather than later, as well as maybe a couple of misused wrestlers or future stars. Those are series that I had done in the past, for those of you that don't know. A couple of those ideas. And again, of course, if you haven't checked out my Q&A video from this past week, then be sure to check that out, because it's up and I answered 21 questions. But it would be cool if you guys check that out just for the hell of it. But be sure to ask me questions for the next one if you'd like me to answer some. I already have, I think, 6 or 7, maybe even 8 by now already. And I like to get to between the 20 and 25 mark. So be sure to ask me more questions for the Q&A video if you can. That would be great. Other than that, everybody enjoy your Christmas, and I will see you later on in the week. So thanks as always for taking the time to watch. Be sure to like if you enjoyed the review. Comment your thoughts on this week's show, etc. And I'll, of course, subscribe for plenty more to come. Thanks as always for watching, and until next time, peace out. Happy holidays.